To create a form, click Forms located on the left side navigation. From here, you'll want to click Create a New Form. Give your form a descriptive name and select a form style you want to create. Styles include inline. This form type is embedded into the content of your page and can be embedded into the sidebar or footer so your contacts can opt in from anywhere. Floating bar. The floating bar is a narrow strip that can appear at the top or bottom of your browser. Floating box is a small box that slides in from the bottom left or bottom right of your browser. And modal. This type is also known as a pop-up and will appear over the page content. In this example, we're going to select inline form. When you create a form, you can add different form actions that will happen as soon as the form is submitted. For example, you can subscribe contacts to a list. You can tag the contact. You can also create a deal for a contact. And you can create a notification that goes out to someone on your team that lets them know how the form is submitted. In this example, we're going to stick with subscribing to a list and adding a tag. Next, click the Create button. Please note that you can use as many actions as you like for your form. You also have the option to add more actions, remove actions, or edit these actions later. The form builder will open and you can start designing your form. You'll see that we've included a form name, as well as descriptive text, which you can change at any time. To the right of the form, you'll see three tabs: Fields, Style, and Options. To add fields to your form, grab the field from the Fields tab located to the right of your screen and drop it into your form. You can change the order of the fields by dragging them, and you can remove fields by selecting it and clicking the X. The Style tab allows you to edit the appearance of your form. You can choose between vertical or horizontal display, change the background color and font color, modify the call to action button. You can also include your own CSS to further customize the appearance of your form. When you're done modifying the appearance of your form, click the Options tab. Here you can choose if contacts should see a message when they submit your form, or you can redirect them to a URL. You can also edit and add additional form actions. If you're using the Subscribes to List action, click the gear icon to the right to display the opt-in confirmation options. You'll see that the double opt-in is enabled by default. The double opt-in is a two-step process that a contact must complete when subscribing to your list. The first step the contact must take is to submit your form. The second step a contact must take is to confirm their interest by clicking on a confirmation link contained in an opt-in confirmation email that is sent to them as soon as they submit your form. The double opt-in process not only ensures that a contact truly wants to hear from you, but can also help you avoid sending emails to fake contacts. You can edit the content and appearance of the opt-in confirmation email by clicking Edit. You can also choose to show contacts a message when they confirm their opt-in or redirect them to a page on your site. To make your form a single opt-in, click the opt-in confirmation toggle to the off position. A single opt-in means that contacts do not have to go through a two-step process of subscribing to your list. Once they submit your form, they are added as active contacts to your list right away. To save any changes, click Save.